and welcome to my channel. Today I have another Halloween video for you, obviously. This time it's about a creepy jester. The whole idea in mind, this isn't inspired by any sort of character, but the idea in mind is sort of like one of those vintage jester clown thingies, you know, the ones on a pack of cards, you know, that type of creepy clown-esque thing. And then from a circus that's probably been like haunted for ages after some gruesome event. Yeah, that's pretty much the idea I had in mind. So yeah, actually this look is surprisingly easy to do. It looks busy, there's a lot going on, which I like. However, it's supposed to look slightly sloppy, worn down, aged, because that's the whole point of the ghostly jester theme. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. Contrary to what I usually do, I'm going to start on my face makeup first this time. I'm just going to use a primer first and then do my usual base of foundation. Immediately going on to powdering, because for an eerie jester I don't want a very nice and bright base, obviously. Because it needs to be creepy. I'm just using a stippling brush ball to add some shading, but mostly to add some dirtiness to my face. Just using a contour powder for that, a very dark one. Because, yeah, just like the idea of my mind is just, you know, a creepy old circus. Something that's been like almost out of business for ages, yet somehow still exists and still has a creepy jester around for some reason. So yeah, I just want to look slightly dirty for this look. I'm using a stippling brush for this because it's easier than to try and paint on a million tiny dots with a actual eyeliner brush or anything like that. Just goes a lot quicker and I like the effect it gives. On my nose, I'm just using a tinier brush very carefully because I want it to be just slightly darker there. And also at the deepest point below my cheekbones. First, I'm using purple and I'm just blending it into my crease with a fluffy blender and also pretty much up to my hairline. Yeah, you could go for any color you want. I'm going to go for multiple shades of purple because I like purple and I want it to be a bit of a mismatch. I'm also not going to blend it perfectly because I want it to look as if it's been on there for like, you know, ages and ages and ages and ages and ages. I'm also blending this below my eye quite heavily. That is going on my actual eyelid with a lavender shade. Just putting a slightly darker shade of purple in the outer corner and the crease, just to deepen it up a little bit more. Don't want to use black for this because I don't want to take away from the grunginess of the black that I'm going to apply later. Then I'm just going to make a very basic sort of grungy eyeliner with a purple pencil. Okay, this one is slightly metallic, but it's more creamy, so I'm going to use this one. I'm just going to go over it with the dark purple eyeshadow just to make it a bit more clean on the outer corners. I'm also going to go around it with black eyeshadow just to prepare for the eyelashes I'm going to add later. And then I'm just putting a black eye pencil on the waterline. Also dragging it to the inner corner just to get sort of a cat eye effect. Then for the markings on the face, I'm going to use a technically a striper brush from a nail art set. If you don't have this, you can also use an eyeliner brush, of course. And for the paint, you can use actual face paint, you can use eyeliner, you can use liquid lipstick, whatever you want. And yeah, just paint it on. You can start this wherever you want. You can start it on top of the eyelid. You can start it way above the eyelid. I wouldn't start it on the actual eyeball because that would probably hurt. I am going to put it over my eyebrow, as you can see, just because I think it would look cool. And sort of just blending it downwards. Below the eye, I'm purposely staying away from the little lines underneath my eye because I don't want it to go creasy there. And other than that, just fill them in the same way. Okay, I didn't know if it would work out, but I actually just managed to make a lip line with this brush, so yeah, I'm going to continue with my lips now. Then it's time for some glitter. And I'm going to use holographic glitter because I'm also going to add some crystal AB stones. I only recently discovered that AB stands for Aurora Borealis. I had no idea. But anyway, yeah, I'm just going to apply the glitter with glitter primer first. I'm actually just going to use it as a highlighter. A very broad highlighter. Put the lighting a little bit lower so you can hopefully see the glitter better. Also going to apply it onto my lips. I'm also going to apply a little bit onto my cheekbones as an actual highlighter. However, I'm using a tinier brush for this, as you can see, because I don't want it to be too much. By the way, if you don't find an eerie gesture, or like a glittery gesture, eerie. Me personally, I find it always pretty hard to judge whether a gesture is eerie or a clown is eerie, because I find them all pretty scary. I don't know, I just don't like clowns. By the way, in the category of amazing timing, it's like raining pretty hard right now, and they're actually, installing a sun shield in our backyard. Yeah, timing is great. Okay, then for lashes, I'm going to use huge and fluffy lashes. And also, like, I always cut a little bit off my lashes so they're not too long. That's the part I'm going to stick beneath my eyes. With the same eyelash glue, I'm also going to apply the little crystals. And here we are, the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. I do a lot of makeup tutorials, and after Halloween I'll also be doing like normal wearable things again. Yeah, I really can't wait until Christmas, like with the glittery, nice smoky eyes and stuff. But yeah, anyway, we're still at Halloween. For this particular look, all the products I've used are below in the description box, or at least the whole like names and all. Of course, you don't need to use the same things that I used. You can just use whatever you have, whatever you like. But in case you want to know names, they're down below. Also, below there, you can find all my social media accounts and names. I'm mostly active on Instagram, and I always share it there as well whenever I upload a new video on here. So I'd really love it if you want to follow me there. And yeah, that was it for today. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!